Hi guys, this is the Innovative Minds Tutor. In this video, we will be focusing on MIP 1502, November 2023. So we will be revising this question paper, question by question. And as we are preparing for 2024, October, November, MIP 1502. So this is our first video for this year. So let's get to the question paper. If you're new to this channel, what are you waiting for? Kindly subscribe. You only subscribe once, right? Let's go. Question one, 1.1. In the table below, you are given expression in weights and the matching algebraic expression. Write the letter of the correct expression next to the matching number. A number is increased by 10. Let that number be X. So they said the number is increased. So let that number be X. So in this case, we will have our solution will be J. So it will be J, which is X plus 10, right? Yes, it will be J, which is X plus 10. Okay. So the product of two different numbers. Let those two numbers be X and Y. So that will be A. That will be A. So we will place A here. The sum of a certain number, the sum of the certain number, and doubled that number. The sum of a certain number, that let it be X. Double with that number, that will be X plus 2. So in this case, we can put I. So half of a certain number multiplied by itself. The half of a certain number multiplied by itself, that will be half X times X, which is a half X squared. So in other words, you are going to have X squared all over 2. We're going to have X squared all over 2 as our solution, meaning that that will be G. We'll place G here. Miss Lucy H in certain years, Miss Lucy H in certain years time, if she's now 29, in certain years, if she's now 29, well, let the if she's 29, so that will be 29 plus X in this case. So we will go with D here. All right. Then 2 less than unknown number. 2 less than an unknown number. Okay. 2 less than an unknown number. So that will be X minus 2 in this case. So we can take C. 2 less than an unknown number. So two less than means that we will subtract in this case. So that will be X minus 2. A certain number multiplied by itself, that will be X times X, which is X squared. So we'll go with E. So we should increment, we should know how to work out with this. These are weight problems. Two consecutive even number, meaning those that follow. So let the first number be X and the second one will be X plus 2. Since so let's take F in this case. We will take F. So a number added to 29, added to itself to 29 times, added. We don't get any, the perfect description will be to repeat D in this case, because all of this doesn't make sense. So we'll go with D. Or if I'm wrong, guys, here, you can also correct me. There's always a room for learning. Yeah, but according to me, I think that number added to 29 times will be D. So let's take D. If you have another solution, you can put it in a comment section so that we help others as well. Remember, our aim is to help each other as we keep learning. A number multiplied by itself to 29 times. That will be X times 29, meaning that will be 29X. So we will go with K. So if you have any comment, you can comment there so that we are able to see whether we did it right or wrong. So they said, explain the value of translating weights into mathematical notation. explain the value of translating words into mathematical notation. The value of translating words into mathematical notation is to help us solve complex problems, guys. It's to help us solve complex problems and real-world situation, and to simplify the problem that we are working with. I hope you will write down. It is to help us solve complex problems and real-world situations or real-life situations, right? Then that's 1.1.2. Then 1.2, in your own words, write down the difference between expression and an equation. The difference between an expression, guys, is that an expression is no equal sign. So, for example, if I have x plus 2, this is an example of an expression. But an equation, you know it because it has an equal sign. So let's say it's x plus 2, which is equals to 4. So an equation has an equal sign. So that's the difference between equation and expression. Expression does not contain an equal sign. An equation has an equal sign. I hope I'm clear in that part. You can also write your own explanation, but that's the perfect explanation for this, right? Or there's no perfect explanation. Well, but it's a simple way of explaining it, right? Right. Let's go to 1.3. The cost of a pencil is X cents, and the cost of a pen is 50 cents, more than the 2/3 of the cost of a pencil. Write down in terms of X the cost of a pen. Let's start with the pen. So let's see be our cost. They said in terms of X, they said 2/3, right? So that would be 2 all over 3, because they said 2/3 of the cost of the pencil. So, and we have the cost of the pencil is what? It's 50 cents. So that will be 2/3, which is 2/3 X plus 50. So that's the 2 marks, right? So they said 3 pens and 2 pencils. So if there are 3 now, we'll say 3 multiplied by 2 all over 3 X plus 50. What is that? Let's punch in your calculator. 2 all over 3 times 3. That will be 2x. Then 3 times 50. That will be 150. So in other words, we can have 2x plus 150 as our expression, right? So we are on our last part on question 1. Last part on question 1, guys. There's always a room for learning. So they said that the recipe for making a beef stew is 25 minutes before cooking for each kilogram plus 40 minutes extra. Let the cooking time for a stew be BT and the mass of a beef and the mass of a beef and stew be M. So they want us to fill this. To fill this, guys, our expression in this case will be, in terms of M, this will be T, which is equals to 45 m. The m, you know where we get it. It's for a beef, right? So 45 m plus what? Plus 40. 45 m plus 40. So once we have this equation, it will help us to find this one. Let's start with the first one. 45 times 1 plus 40. That will be 85. If you plug 2 now, what are we getting? Punch your calculator. We are getting 130. If you plug it, what are we having? 175. If we put 6 here, what are we having? We are having 310. If we put 11, what are we having? 535. Right. So that's how you can get this one. You must have an equation so that you're able to fill this part, right? So the caterer has to cook the beef stew for 40 guests. Each guest is expected to consume 200 of stew. How long will it take to cook the stew? So that will be T, 45. Since they said, why am I putting it? Okay. We are on the last part. The caterer is to cook the beef stew for 40 guests. Each guest is expected